Welcome to another episode of Let's Play Minecraft Series 2. We are here on episode number 40 of this series. I do appreciate everybody who has come out. Hope that your guys' time zone is doing wunderbar. Excuse me, if you're watching here on Twitch, I do apologize for the late start. It seems to be that, despite the fact that I'm trying to get to sleep and all that, for the, to be able to be here, that, well, I'm just not getting to sleep, so, you know. Sigh. Alright, so on today's agenda is, we are going to be, doing, we're going to be doing a, thing where, we're going to be working on our item sorter, and from that, with all that, we're going to also, of course, be, hopefully, knock on wood, covering things up. So, at least, you know, putting that decorative wall on it is what I mean, of course. So, let's see here. Boop. There's that. Gosh darn it. I don't know why. I just suddenly started thinking of Space Oddity by David Bowie. You know, ground control to Major Tom. Just a sec. Sorry about that. It was a white cat wanting attention. I know I really didn't publicize it, but let's see. Today is Thursday. On Tuesday, had to take white cat back to the vet because basically, over the last couple, about like 4 or 5 days at least, been noted that he'd been pissing in unusual places, not his usual litter box. And it was like, what the heck, white cat? Why aren't you doing your stuff in your litter box? So, took him to the vet, Tuesday evening, and, let me get, this going, flick over to the main screen. So, yeah, took him to the vet on Tuesday, gave a rundown, Tree Dad and I, gave a rundown of what was happening, and, basically, we, let's see here, oh wait, I just pulled up the wrong, I was like, wait a minute, why am I in another wart farm? That's not the thing I'm looking for. There we go. Oh, alright. So anywho, gave the vet the rundown of stuff with White Cat. They said we're gonna go ahead here. We want to hold on to him, watch him overnight, that sort of thing. We're like, yeah, do what you need to do. So. It's the fact that he is getting old as a cat, because they were able to determine that he had a bladder infection and his kidneys aren't doing so well. So that is why over the last couple days, there was some trouble with him. Deliberately sort of hold off on that little bit of stuff there. So, we now have a lot more hoppers. Huzzah. Huzzah for hoppers. Alright. So yeah, it's basically the fact that White Cat is getting old. He recently turned 15. So he is for a cat, he's been around. Striped cat, my family's first cat. She got to live till 18 in human years. And so, that was quite some thing. So, here on this stuff, what we're going to do is we're going to start off, basically what I want to do is, we're going to leave this sort of thing here open. The part of the stuff here that we can leave open for the stuff. Now, at the very top there, we're going to have that. We're going to have to close that up, because in order to meet up with the stuff up topside. So, let's go ahead here. Gonna grab a bunch of hoppers. Summon reserve. Grab a whole bunch of chests. Oh, excuse me. White Cat, what's up?
You see, I can.
Sorry about that. Yeah, White Cat wanted out. At least we got I got some medication for him, so as that he we could take care of his bladder infection. Up. I think what we'll do, since I know I can. Since I know I can then goof, stuff like that. On this, I think about it. I think we'll only build up a couple levels on this. That way we can focus, at least for a time. Oops. At least focus for a time on And then we'll do the, and then we'll finish up doing the hopper stuff, actually. Now that I think a little about it a little bit more. One of those classic times where you run out of stuff in your hot bar. Now we'll only build up a couple layers here, just enough to be able to get at least started on the on the wall. And then we'll start doing the rest of the hoppers. Actually, let's see here. Now, let's do all the layers. I was thinking that, oh geez, I forgot to finish building that up too. Silly twee! That's another thing we're gonna have to do today. See, I figured that, and I was getting a look at all the hoppers. I mean, I was like, this is probably not enough. I wish I'd been able to get more mining done, but of course IRL decided to be a butt. Alright, so before we get, let's see here, what we'll come do is we need to go fix that. Let's get, let's go quickly, we'll just do, hoppers right here. Our chest right here. These two here on the end, they'll probably become the obligatory overflow chests. Lots of hoppers. Let's come over here. Snag a little bit more polished blackstone. And he's polished a little bit more in the basalt. And then sure we snag plenty of a stone brick. Got myself my non-fortune pick. So as I remember discussing with you guys, let's see here. So that's gonna be blackstone, so. But yeah, as I remember discussing with you guys, the theme of the actual wall covering is going to be not the stuff we put on the floor, the basalt and blackstone, but rather a nether brick and blackstone brick combination. Oops. Tree almost done goof there. Okay, we are here at essentially here at the there is that. So we're going to need to come up three. One, two, three. One, two, three. Surprised I didn't just fill these last two blocks in with stone brick. But then again, Twee was being Twee. Here on the end, we have this way of getting around. We can just fill those in. We'll take those four signs there. Ooh, what we could do is this is a thing we need to do, actually. We need to take some of our hoppers. And we need to build this area. Excuse me. We need to get the filter set up. Need to get the hopper lines and feed lines installed. The distribution bits. So let's take a leisurely stroll back downstairs. Boom for all these guys. Signs back. Oops, I forgot to make a deposit. Let's go make our deposit. It'll be balanced. Yeah. I can't wait to get this covered up. Well, you can see the system at work here. The blackstone's come through. Ow. That hurt. Thinking back to The Hobbit, An Unexpected Journey, the part where Bilbo is narrating the stuff for Erebor, you know, in the before Smaug came, you know, he goes, "Ah, Frodo, Erebor." You know, and he goes, you know, on this detailed explanation of stuff. Of, you know, the wealth and, you know, the abilities of the, of the city, of the interiors. And all that jazz. Jeez, this is bloody expensive. I knew it'd be this. I kind of forgot how bloody expensive this stuff can be at times. Alright, so let's see here. I want to make sure I sort of keep the theme here going of the chests opening, at least, you know, the ones hidden. So, you know, so you guys can see, you know, they go to the left. this case, it's just going to be easier to do this one step at a time. Yeah, I'm suddenly thinking about the Hobbit there. Almost missable thing there. So when we get to the walls here in a bit, what we're basically going to do is do a thing where we'll do a little bit of prep work first. For stuff. It will be a better idea to, like I said, we'll at least do I'm just trying to decide how many levels I want to do. Because I know that now taking a look-see at stuff, I definitely have nowhere near enough hoppers. But at least we got a nice start. Use the right button tree. Buttons, I should say. Probably have to go visit the tree farm, stuff, make some more, chests eventually, but not today, so that's just good. Gosh, I'm remembering in one of the games I play, it's an occasional playthrough that I do. It's a game called Cossacks, Back to War. It's the third expansion of the original Cossack game by GCS World. And it's a standalone. Didn't have to worry back in the day of having had the base Cossacks game and it's in the first expansion, The Art of War. And have stuff to make it run. But, let's see, probably take it up to, the equivalent of that height right there. We're gonna put the chests here. Then the hoppers, and then the equivalent of these guys on top of them. So let's see, I'm gonna quickly do that. So, but anyway, back to the Cossacks thing. You know, there would be times when I'm playing the game and Treedad would ask me, why are you spam clicking all your 18th century grenadiers? And so, you know, why aren't you using formations? And I was like, because in this case, I don't want to have to worry about organizing, because anytime you have casualties in a formation, you have to go through this tough process of filling them up, or you have to disband and you have to either do that, you know, go through the complex process of refilling, or you have to disband the formation and reform it. And I was like, I'm not going to do that. I'm just here to conquer the poop out of my enemies. So why not just go ahead and go through and have sort of this ungangly horde of grenadiers, you know, about 2,000 or more, about 2,500 or more grenadiers to come through and have bash the poop out of the guys. Excuse me again. And, you know, take their peasants for myself. And, so yeah, that's basically what I do in that game is, you know, get myself up and running, get my army made, and go bash some baddies. Let's see here. I wonder if there's a wiki. Excuse me. There's a Cossacks wiki. Let me see here. I'm gonna check. I'm not sure. Let me see. Do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do. Maybe. Ah, well, there's not much to it, to the Cossacks wiki, or at least the one I found. There's a link to Back to War. Yeah, basically, you know, I would just set myself up, to be able to have the fun of, bashing baddies. So, let's see. Excuse me. Let's go ahead. We'll put in our initial hopper right there. Yeah, once we get this side and the other side done, we'll go ahead and start working on the walls for the cover of the item sorter here. I'm not gonna worry about the building the whole thing today. I just at least wanted to get started. I figured once I got a better look at all the hoppers I had, I was like, oh geez. Nowhere near enough. And yeah, I went did plenty of mining. Were able to make plenty of hoppers, but still nowhere near frickin' enough, you know? That's one of the things you can do in Cossacks, is you can mine iron. Because in sort of like Age of Empires, Age of Mythology, sort of thing, is you have various resources that, you can use to build your civilization. Just like in AOM and AOE2, you start off with some resources and peasants. Instead of villagers, they're called peasants. Even though I try to be a little more kind and I call my actual peasants villagers, because it's just it's the while historically accurate, it's also doesn't make me feel nice, so that's why I call them peasants. Despite it not being villagers instead of peasants. Blah, blah, blah. There's that side. Let's go ahead here. Put that bad boy in. As soon as we get the hoppers and chests on this side built, we'll go ahead and start to build the exterior wall. But when it comes to Cossacks, you start off, same sort of thing, some resources and some villagers. You gotta build, unlike Age of Mythology, a little more in line with Age of Empires 2 and all that, you can choose where you place your town center, only in this case it's a town hall. And you basically just go ahead and build at least one, if not several, town halls. And then once you get done with that, you basically start building up your stuff. You got barracks, blacksmiths, stables, cannon workshops. I'm momentarily blanking out on what they're called. basically, you know, you build up your stuff, your research center, your academies, which are your research main research center for most everything. There are some buildings, you know, like the barracks that have, you know, unit specific material that you need to research for them. Others, like I said, the academy, which is sort of, you know, your civ-wide research. And So basically, you can start out just like AoE 2 and AOM. Basically, ow. Well, not that. Do your research and all that. And then start bashing the heck out of your enemies and win. And this is just for a random map. A tree is the type. He likes to, there's this thing in this particular game called peacetime. Basically, what happens is, sorry, I had to stretch. What you do is come on, tree, use your words. Let's see here, chisel another brick. Start picking up our nether brick stuff. Basically, you can't attack anybody. I don't want the shroom lights. And, basically what you're doing, oops. Stuff I'm looking for is over, excuse me, is over here. There we go. And, if you do send, your military forces into enemy territory. Wait. I don't want stone brick. Basically, if you do send your troops into enemy territory, your enemies have the right, and they will, of course, go ahead and do such. They will defend themselves. And your troops will instantaneously kick the can. So silk touch. Don't want to forget that for glowy glow. Oh, I do need one thing of a couple things here. Just go ahead. We'll chuck all our stuff here. What am I thinking? Need to get the, let's see here. Stone brick back out. Need to get the stuff here done. The maintenance access. Of course, because we've turned the corner here, right there, we're going to have to figure out how we're going to do this. Just may have to go ahead. Simplest solution is to go ahead, knowing that we have to cover up to there. I'm thinking that we'll just go ahead and, that's an idea. Can do is sort of have the wall. We could sort of incorporate it into this, you know, have it come out. Ooh, that is an idea. Basically, sort of come out, sort of have it come out, you know, two steps, and then be able to finish up doing like that. Ooh, that is an idea. That is an idea. let's go ahead here and get, we'll also have to do one on the back side as well. Or at least I remember that. Let's go, well, before I go around installing stuff, we'll double check. There's that. Brings us up to there. So, das ist gut. What I'll probably do is, probably find, yeah, we're gonna have to cover this whole darn thing up. Well, at least we got that part in. I'm not gonna complain too much about that. So before we done goof, before we double done goof, let's, go quickly OCD ourselves. Make sure we should have, or at least I think we should have. Yes, we're gonna have to do on both sides. So probably what we'll do is come in and install a fence. But we'll make it, we'll do the same thing on the other side. So, let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, all right, 1, 2, probably do is a, have to figure this out. I'm gonna at least go ahead here and install this side. I'm gonna leave the bricks there for now until we get stuff installed here. What I'm gonna do is just do the standard build out whilst crouched sort of thing. Come on. He's like, come on, Twee, why aren't you building? Oh, wait, I need to move my cursor. Department of Dot. Yeah, on Cossacks, I just typically would use a couple hours worth of peace time to allow myself to get built up. And then pre-position my troops, because, like I said, basically I would... reposition my troops, because that way I wouldn't have to worry about waiting for actual quote unquote wartime to get let's go ahead and make access, temporary access here while I'm thinking about it. I wouldn't wait for actual wartime to be able to it's raining outside. Correction! It's a thunder boom. It's a thunder boom. Where in the oh geez. I love thunder. I love watching lightning and thunderstorms IRL. I don't like it so much here in Minecraft. It's lit. It's a good thing that I went ahead and installed that thing. We could do it like this. Oops. I hate when I do that. So, yeah, basically I will do in Cossacks, pre-position my forces in enemy territory because the AI were kind of dumb in this regard. They would keep all their troops literally in their what would pass for their town, city, their settlement, and they would essentially, they would send out guard, because one of the things that you could do in Cossacks is you could capture buildings. Military buildings you can't capture, you have to destroy them, but civilian buildings you can capture, or at least most civilian buildings. There's a couple, cathedral... That's it. I'd have to go double check, but basically that I'd capture the civilian buildings, the ones I could capture, and then at the same time, I'd be wiping out their enemy forces. Basically, with the pre-positioned troops, once peacetime was over, I would, start capturing certain civs, because there's a certain order of which, we're talking, like Austria, Hungary, England, Russia, France, a whole bunch of different, nations. That you can play as, and excuse me, and basically there's a certain way, depending on how the game goes, that you can, the particulars of your game, of where your civ is on the list and your enemy's civ. Let's see here. Let's go ahead and re-get what I was aiming to get. It's also gonna need these guys as well. So some of these guys are gonna have to get left behind. Take all our glowy glow. I have. It's not gonna be there. I'm wondering. Wait, did I put it in the thing? Let's quickly double check out here. Horse stuff back. That's it. Well, woof yourself there, cow. There it is. Fix him up. Well, that answers that question. Let's go ahead here. Oh, wait a minute. Do I really have to craft some? Let me see here. The answer is yes. The answer is yes. So, let's see here. Go ahead here. On, go back. There we go. Now that's less wussity. All right, so what I'm going to do first is let's see here. Once again, I've done goofed. I done goofed. Take those guys there. What we're gonna do, first things first, is we're gonna take out the Blackstone. Come here. There we go. We're still gonna retain the theme up to a point, but we're essentially gonna swap out the basalt here for another brick. Now we're gonna keep the theme, the floor theme, going here behind. I know that it's gonna be one of these things where we're not gonna be quite as much back behind, but the same time, want stuff to be standardized. Least here on the front side. Now, oh, yeah, we're gonna keep the wood. Yeah, the tar coat, that's gonna stay. Let's see. I hate when I got multiple types like that. See here. And I didn't put the one thingy back. How did I? Those get nothing for that those guys had been installed yet. Let's see here. Boom, boom, stair chiseled in stairs should be pillar then chiseled. Piller than chiseled. Excuse me. That's just what I needed to know. All right, so here we'll have some ease of work. With the glowstone though, don't gotta worry quite so much. We'll come worry about that stuff here in a sec. Because I want to get this little bit done while I'm thinking about it, because I'm easily destructible. Take that polished blackstone and actually pick up some more blackstone bricks. Those guys there. Excuse me. Earlier I was just putting the item frames out so I knew that they were on the field, you know? I wish we could make a polished basalt stairs. Unfortunately, we can't do that. So what we're gonna do here with the wall is we're basically gonna be doing it as if the floor here was turned on its side. You know, if you know, we're raising the floor up to height, that is. And that'll be for both that the one we've already done some work on, and of course the side we're currently working on. Excuse me. Excuse me again. There's that. Now we gotta come through with these other guys and busily do them. At least this time we're only gonna have one instead of two. Come on, there we go. I kind of spoke, of course. I kind of spoke too soon. Oops. There's a guy that got misplaced. Installed stairs yet. Could do that. There's that. That finally the last thing we need to worry about with this, and we can finally do this. All right. Tree just gave himself ideas. She just gave himself some ideas. So, let's go ahead here. Oops. Hate when I do that. I'm gonna chuck, do that. There we go. There we go. Ready? Ouch. All right. So, Tree just gave himself an ideas. Blaze. There we go. Yes. Let's see here. Let's go to our hello. I know it's here somewhere. Not my drops. What's that? There we go. Grab pressure plates. Feels right. Get some doors there. And we'll even do the same here. We'll have to probably come in and just do something here with this little bit. That would be an idea too, is to come through with the back wall stuff right here, feed that through, and also have access to the front and over here. And then, you know, we'll have to, of course, put in walls and all that. But, yes! You see, this, you know, as you build stuff up, you start getting ideas. Yes, get ideas, Tree. Get ideas. Do I have any more bloody beds? If I have to make up another bed, I'm gonna be pissed at myself. Food, tools. You know what? I'm gonna have to make up another bed. So let's see here. Wood. Actually, gosh, darn it. I just started thinking about ELO's Don't Bring Me Down. Don't Bring Me Down, Groups. You know, that's a common, from my understanding, what's his face? The leader of ELO. Or frontman, whatever his name is, I'm forgetting. He made the sound, people think he's saying Bruce when he's actually saying Groose. And what he'll do at ELO concerts is, he'll actually troll people by saying Bruce. Don't bring me, because, you know, it sounds, because the way he sounds Groose is, it sounds like Bruce. And so what he'll actually do is he'll actually troll people by actually saying Bruce at concerts. Oh, I need to put what's it away? Put the basalt away. Ready? Ow. Do have some stuff here. Alright, so what we're gonna do here is DOS plan that I have. Yes, Twee, as per normal, at least has something of a plan. Let's put our didn't I have more netherrack stairs? No, more nether brick stairs? I thought I did. I need more nether brick stairs. Let's see here. Guess not. Well, let's go ahead here. Just make up at least some more. Get another stack of nether brick. So the plan is to, excuse me, we'll bring all our stuff get the spare another brick stairs out of the way. So, because of the way chests operate, I cannot put a solid block right here. Because if I put a solid block right there, I cannot access that chest. And normally, historically, I'll at least put a stair right here, because, you know, that a stair is, you know, if I just do that, allows the chest to be open. But because of this guy right here, we're going to be doing the change up. So what I'm going to do is going to bring out our the equivalent of our stairs here. That way you can sort of kind of see in behind just a little bit, but once we get these guys built, it's just going to be easier to build here from the ground and, you know, carefully look up and and do our stuff here. Oh, we also are going to need some dark oak stairs, too. I should have some of those outside, so. Now, what we're going to do first is I'll just put those two bad boys there. Nether brick. Have to remember to go get some dark oak. Make sure we're up to theme standard here. All right, so let's see here. Oops. Something in my tree. I hate when that happens. Two. Oops, not that tree. Don't be a dum dum. Three. Oopsie poopsies. I was like, wait a minute, something's off here. What in the bloody blazes did I do wrong now? And I was like, oopsie poopsies. Three. Here I am. I'm feeling a little bit like I'm trying to build something, you know, for the first time, and, you know, I'm a new player. Oh, that's lined up. It's building stuff up like this that can be difficult at times, you know? Oops. Oh, wait. Just in and out. Thank you, Marbles, for the host. See here. Let's quickly do that. Oh, you're gonna boop. May I? Well, I counter boop you, Bubbles! Boop! Oops. Oopsie poopsies. I hate when I do that. There we go. Gosh darn it, Bubbles. I'm suddenly thinking about doing I'm suddenly thinking of I think it was season 6 of Red versus Blue. Or at least that's what I'm remembering, where they had a crossover to the, at the time, the new Achievement Hunter division of Rooster Teeth. And Caboose doing the sound effects for Xbox Achievement went bleep bloop, bleep bloop. And he got me thinking with boop, bleep bloop, bleep bloop, bleep bloop. Come on, Twee, you can do this. Wait, am I? Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness. Twee has been done goofage. He has been doing things wrong. Yeah, it was, I think it was for the 360. Twee has done goofed again. See, oh, wait. Wait, did I did have it right, I think. No, wait, no, I didn't. No, I didn't. No, I didn't goofed. Let's see, this'll be Blackstone. Oops. Yeah, Department of Duh. Oh, wait. Almost done goofed again. Almost done goofed. Because we're following the theme of the wall. We're doing the wall. So, let's see. This needs to be... There we go. Oh my goodness. Twee has just realized that this part is the done goofed. This part is the done goofed. Super Department of Da Burbles. See, this part here is right. This part here is right. That part there is right. Let's see. Because we see, we got right here, because we want where we got the basalt. We're switching that out to nether brick. I think of it is. I'm going to remove this bit. Just going to put up a placement block right there. I'm going to have to figure this part out. We might have to go with something different here. Try this again with less done goofage. Yeah, Burbles. Thanks a lot. You got me thinking of bleep bloop, bleep bloop, bleep bloop. I got so many achievables. I'm surprised. I haven't seen that video, that particular video, in years, and I'm surprised I'm remembering those particular little bits of trivia. Silly Burbles. Just making sure we're lined up. Don't want a Department of Duh stuff more than I have to. I hate when I do Department of Duh. Like that right there. Gosh, I don't remember. Even I don't remember how I came up with that. Department of Duh. I think it was sort of, you know, inspired by, you know, like a Department of Motor Vehicles sort of thing. And, wait a minute. No, wait. Tree, you're overthinking. times to think, tree, but, you've already established the theme. I have not watched Pokemon since Johto League. And I haven't played since same generation. God, I haven't played Pokemon in years. And Song of Storms, that's Zelda, right? At least that's what I'm remembering from seeing people play, right? I can't, with me busy, so busy at work, it's a little harder to help keep track of stuff, you know? Raining again. Oh, wait. Tree almost done goofed again. Yeah, I thought so. I thought my tree memory was clicking into gear there. Or at least I was hoping my tree memory was clicking into gear there. Oopsie poopsies! Almost done goofed again. Yeah, it's not the only Zelda game that I really ever seriously played. Was as a much younger tree playing Wind Waker. Red from Crystal, what's that, if you don't mind me asking? Please enlighten me, Bubbles. Alright, let's see here. I should have... Let's see here. Let's make a small closet. Mostly of our stone brick. I mean, our nether brick. Let's go get some dark oak. Oh, wait. Tree done goofed! Tree's done goofed! Or I think he thinks he's done goofed. He has definitely done goofed. Let's see. Hello. Tree may have super done goofed. Thank the gaming gods, I do have some dark oak skills, but I need more dark oak! Tree! I just went ahead and took all the dark oak I had, and I made it into chests for the hoppers. tree. Ah. I remember playing Pokemon. Oh. My brain farted there. That shows it's been a while since I played Pokemon. Now it's coming back to me. Yeah, red, the Gen 2 champion. And all that. This is my tree brain just went. Ugh. Oops. Tree is realizing he is done goofing. Well, sounds like it. I remember leveling up my team in Silver and Crystal. Basically, to where, you know, using the Elite Four as my, come on, there we go, using the Elite Four as my, final, training stuff, and that way I could still get up to level 100 on all my Pokemon. I thought, if I'm going to smite the Elite Four, I might as well continue to smite them and level up. Oh, you're the same thing, huh? Level up to level 100 and use the Elite Four? Thou shalt be smited. You see, for tree, I would usually get to play. Because Tree Mom would have to take me to school. For my later years, because bus service couldn't quite reach. Just a second. White Cat wants in. Just a second. Sorry about that, White Cat. You, sir, needing to go to the Victor Echo Tango. Yeah, it's my later years, you know, going through secondary school. White Cat, what you doing? White Cat, what you doing? Just a second. Let me pick him up.
Hello. Hi.
Guess what, guys? We're gonna get some White Cat ASMR! Just getting him warmed up with the purrin. And here we go. We had a little bit of White Cat ASMR. I would just, you know, yay, yes indeed. He is a jet engine. He can purr quite loudly, especially if he wants, especially if he slides into attention needing mode, burbles. He can really turn on his purring jet engine. His purr engine. But yeah, I would just, you know, I would have sort of my main team of Pokemon. I would try to have a different. I think it was the way I tried to have it set up. Is I'm not sure if my. I think it's the cartridge I got for Silver is. I think the battery's probably, with that being, you know, 20 years ago, I would get to play it on the way to and from school, but in later years, I remember having a tree mom take me to school, and by then I was, you know, doing a little bit more reading, but I remember, you know, like, being on the bus in the first initial years of Tree Mom having to take me to school because of the bus service stuff, being able to play games, but then of course I went and started just doing more reading. One of the things I remember was having my team. As I remember. In Silver version, I think it was the way I had it set up was I know I had Lugia. I think it was the three legendary dogs. You know, jeez, White Cat, you butt. Just a second. I'll tell ya, Burbles, White Cat is an attention needer mode. He's daddy, give me attention. Ugh, silly White Cat. Time for more White Cat ASMR. You, sir, are an attention-needing kitty. But you're my kitty. And I am your twee. Yes. I'm talking to you. He's here rubbing one of my branches. Scenting me. That's what, you know how Quirky says, face wubs, burbles. I call them whenever, you know, he uses, brushes against me. I call them scentings. He is adorable. But yeah, I call them scentings, because, you know, he's scenting, because, you know, for a cat, they're, I think it's their primary scenting glands are there here on their face, are there with their whiskers. This is why they scent there. And it's because I know that's where those scent glands are. That is why I call them scentings. Yeah. He's in attention-needing mode, so just a second. He wants out. So back finally to Pokemon. So as I'm trying to remember, I'd have to go. I got it somewhere. Both my GBA and my silver cartridge, but I'm not sure if the battery on my silver cartridge is still any good. The game's like, you know, 20 years old. What I would do, is have my team, as I was saying. So it was, Lugia, the three legendary dogs, Raikou, Entei, and Suicune. So that's four. The psychic evolution of Eevee, Espeon. There we go, Espeon. It took my canopy a moment there to recollect what I wanted, and some other Pokemon. I'm not sure what. That's the what I can remember, at least. Or at least I think that's the way I had my setup. You know, I would try to get different types, you know, like how Lugia was flying psychic. I think, as I remember... Ooh! I need to get, part of me is considering doing at some point if I could figure out how to do it and, not have issues, getting Pokemon, not Pokemon, a Nintendo console of some kind, and handheld, and doing some Nintendo streaming. But of course, I know that, or at least I know that historically, Nintendo has not been, so sanguine about having their content streamed, despite the fact that, you know, they have made some pretty popular content. So I would have to do some of my research on that before I seriously went in and did any Nintendo streaming, because I don't want to, you know, either here on Twitch or on my YouTube channel. I don't want to get, you know, hit for that. Quickly head to bed, pick up a few things on the route. Yeah, I'd have to do some research into that. I've already done a little bit, but I'd have to essentially do a lot more in-depth research. And, if I was able to find, you know, all the information I would want, I would really honestly love to be able to, I'm not sure if I'd do it on stream or here on Twitch or what. I might just may make it, you know, sort of a YouTube exclusive series. Might do a, you know, a pre-recorded series on the Wind Waker, Legend of Zelda: The Wind Waker. I still have my GameCube, but I'd either have to somehow get a capture card, and I'm not sure that I'm certain I could find it, and I'd have to get, you know, a capture device because. Obviously, these days we're dealing with DVI, HDMI, DisplayPort, but of course it's the old, more traditional RGB or whatever it is for the GameCube. And obviously, I would have to go get, if I wanted to play the console version, I'd have to. Make sure I went and got myself a capture device. Whether it be, you know, a data card or some sort of USB device. I'd have to take a look-see into that sort of stuff. Yeah. Yeah, there's splitters. I know what you're talking about there, Burbles. I just have to do my, like I said, I just have to do my research. If I was able to, you know, go through virtual Nintendo Virtual Console, and did something to there, used the more modern systems and went through the store and Nintendo Store and all that, the Virtual Console, that would save. That would save some time and trouble. it's not. I wouldn't quite classify that as weird burbles because it's both USB. You're both regular USB-A and USB-C. I have the same thing for my phone. Basically, the port on my phone is USB-C. And I have a cord. The cord I have for my phone has it can plug into a regular two-prong outlet, but at the same time, the cord itself is detachable, and on the detachable end where it plugs into the outlet adapter for the two-prong is a USB-A. So I could literally plug it in to my computer or my laptop, and you know, if I want to, you know, transfer, you know, like photos from my computer to from my phone to my computer, I could do that. Or if, you know, if I want to transfer like some music or videos, I could do that too. Yeah. Well, you see, there is, that is a bit weird, actually. Because normally, on your device, that is the female part. So, you know, if you take, if you look-see at, you know, your phone, or if you've got, like, a tablet, the port is the female, all right? And the actual bit on the cord is the male. Let me see here. Just a second. I'm going to put on my break screen. I'm going to pull up my, let's see here. All right, here, Burbles. Let me do that. All right, so this right here, this is the male part, all right, on a cord. And this right here is female. So basically, you know, this is type C right here. And this is type A, type B. That's, you know, the square type. And then we've got, you know, USB 3, mini, micro C, micro B. This is actually what I got here on my external drive right here is my 3 tera drive is I've got a micro B. And then it goes to type USB-C. I mean, USB 3. Don't know why I said C. But, you know, the male part is the part you insert into your device. That is the male, and the receptacle is female. You know, it's sort of, you know, they're very much following biology in this case. So that's it's a little bit of our tech lesson for the day. So yeah. All right, let's see here. We've got, that'll be more, should hopefully be more than enough in terms of our stuff. All right, let's see here. I should I should now have enough. At minimum for our replanting stuff. Let's put our chest. There's that. Now we've got enough, so we'll just chuck those guys into the system there for composting. Let's go ahead here. Since we got plenty of dark oak, let's make up some more stairs, shall we? There we go.
No.
Hello, cow. Let's go ahead here. Do that there. Do this here. There we go. And now what we'll do is just need something with which to build, so I'm gonna do first thing is let's come out a little bit so I can have a little bit of workspace here. Let's see here. Boop. We're gonna have to go take our break here in a moment, but I want to get that built up. Wait, did I? I done goofed. I'm overthinking again. Overthinking again. Again. I may have overdone this. I'm gonna do that so I have headroom here. Yeah, I overdid it. In this case, I actually underdid it. Because I want the the stuff here. Like that. There we go. So, what I'm gonna have to do is come around. Let's just, debris. Missing a thing of redstone there. Let's go pick that up from top side. There we go. see here. Put those bad boys there. Oops. Oopsie poopsies. Let's see here. There's that. We'll take our break here in a moment. I know I said that a moment ago. What we can do to help save some time and trouble. Help us get us going a little bit faster here. I know it's kind of dark. I'm not sure how well it's coming across for you guys. It's probably not too well. But even I'm barely seeing this. All right, that should be where I want us to be. Yes. Huzzah! We did it! See, I'm going to get rid of this. I know it's hard to see. All right, there we go. There we go. You can see now we kind of got it going there. So, let's go... Let's go ahead here, guys. We're going to take our break. So, yeah, go ahead and stand up, stretch, get something to eat, get something to drink, use the restroom. See y'all here in a few minutes. Hey guys, Trey is back. So, let me quickly just move about here for a sec. Settle back in. Let's see here. So now let's go ahead here. We'll do the same thing over here. Forgot. I was like, I'm short a block, and I was like, where is it? There it is. Department of Duh. Excuse me. Oops. Let's see here. I'm gonna get some glowstone this time so I have some light so I can see better and so you guys can see. And let's go ahead here. We'll just wait on that. Let's see, we're a little closer this time. Going to let's lower one level. Put that there so I can better see. See here. Should be the same. Yep. All right. Go ahead here. We're going to put out, oops, not quite like that tree. And then, tree just gave himself an idea. Put some should I put glowstone there?
Yeah.
So this is why. Glowstone here. I can help with future lighting. I may be small. See here, we're gonna have to build. I'm suddenly thinking about a Dan Bull's Arch Illager rap. A song. Let's go ahead and pick up this bit of glowy glow. There we go. That's all built up. Huzzah! Slight adjustment over there. Ow. There we go. Yeah, that's better. That gives a little bit of light on the inside for services, and we'll just come over here and make a slight adjustment over here. That's right. Got the additional layer there. I'll just come around like that. Go ahead here and put that there. At least for the time being, it'll help illuminate stuff. All I'm really starting to think of Dan Bull's Arch Illager rat now. I may be small, but I'm kind of a big deal. Yeah, there we go. So, excuse me, what we'll do now is we'll do this one side at a time. You know, we'll do that section first, then this section. Then we'll do this section here, and then do that section there. You know, it's one little step at a time. Let's go ahead here. There we go. Where's the thing that's got all our stairs in it? And dark oak. Just put our there. Let's see. This also gives us the strategic advantage here of being able to more easily place our stairs, and we've got that figured out. Let's see here. I'm going to quickly organize my hotbar. We'll wait here a little bit before we move over to the to the thing. So let's see here. We'll start off first by placing here on our guys here. The obligatory things. So actually gonna need yes, I have some room. So what I need to do first is this. Three. There we go. It's like, come on, tree, you can do this. There's that. Oops. At least we got a space to where we can easily ascend and get stuff placed. So all right, let's see here. One, two, come on, two, three, one, are actually here at a good spot. No, I knew that this part wouldn't be perfect. I knew this part wouldn't be perfect by any means, but yes, the inevitable B-U-T-T. But yes, I did say that. But in this case, let's first see where we are. Let's make sure that I am where I want to be. Yeah. And actually taking a look see at that. Yeah, that is more or less what I wanted. May actually have to do a little bit of rearrangement. Well, actually, since it's plugged in. Oh wait, yeah, that's right. Duh. Let's see here. I should have thought about this a little bit more. Yeah, we need to do some reworking, but fortunately, it's not going to be too much reworking. Yeah. See what happens if you apply a little bit. Oh, pick, come back. There we go. See what happens if you apply just a little bit more thought to your process here, tree. At least we won't have to worry about redoing every single gosh darn thing. No, we just did all this, but in this case. Just use our fortune pick. I'm going to take out these two things of wood. Dark oak. If I need to. Should I get this? See, having that little side bit there actually has helped us out. Let's go pick up our debris now, so I don't lose anything. So I don't have to worry too much about redoing stuff here. Let's see here. Let's make sure I go pick up the stuff that's falling behind as well. I was like, where in the hell heck am I? I know I just said hell. My bad. Sorry. All right. So what I need to do is tear this stuff out. So basically, I'm going to reset. system here. Won't be quite as built in as I would have, in this case, preferred. But, yes, the inevitable B-U-T-T. Panic. Let's see. Jeez, always. Physically gotta get rid of some of this stuff. Boom, boom, boom. All right, polished. All right. Oops, I quite like that tree. Excuse me. It's there. That and then the stairs. There we go. Yeah, I'll fix the rest of it later. Let's see, one, two, three. All right. Let's head back up. Start reworking our stuff. Let's make sure we yank out our stairs. I just heard White Cat. And there he is. Just a second there, White Cat. White Cat, once again, is in attention need mode. Give me attention, tree dad. Give me attention. Oh, wait. Dum dum. Dum dum. All right. There we go. That's better. That's better. See here, I need to make sure I do my stairs, so all right, let's see here, there's one, two, and then we'll do that'll be number three on top. one head on up here. These guys bring out our dark oak logs again. See, this is what a little fixin' work can do, guys. When you realize, hey, tree. Be less of a dum-dum, less of a dum-dum, oops. So touch pick. For a reason, my count is off on the my blackstone. Forget something up there? Shouldn't have. Let's go ahead here. While I'm up here, I'm just going to do this. That gives us a little bit of light. Ow. Maybe it's because I made an adjustment to stuff here. That's probably why my count is off. Yeah. Look at that, it's sort of like coming out a little bit. And then let's see, let's put up the rest of our stuff here and see how the rest of this wall's gonna look. Oops. Let's see here. 1, 2, 3. Maybe it's because I haven't done this part. That's probably why it's off. So what this does is it helps us out by actually providing light. So in this case, not only does it light up the wall from the outside, it helps prevent baddies from spawning within on the inside. So in this case, it's actually doubly beneficial system. As it does two things literally at once. Three. Do our thing here again. I don't think we're going to be able to get to the oops. Almost a goof there. I don't think we'll be able to get to the programming additional smelter stuff today. It's all right. Not the end of the world. Rather try to get the good stuff done versus not so good stuff. All right, so let's go ahead here. Since I'm now starting to bash my head against the thing here, that's because we got our thing. Let's take a look. Oh yeah, what would really make this sort of work is if we did the stuff here on the corners. The glowstone. The other guys, I think that'll be enough for the stuff there. Oh, yes! That is a thing of beauty! Let's go get our fallen debris. My OCD is going haywire. What's the, this? So 1, 2, 3. There's that. Ha ha ha. Yes! That is looking swell. Alright, so what we need to do is let's see here, boom, what we need to do, just use some stuff here as our construction material, our scaffold material. I'm gonna come out a little bit so that we have some operating room. Just checking my height. See here. I'm going to momentarily throw my OCD into haywire. I'm going to do that so that it's like, hey, tree, there's where you go down. And then now we're starting to run out of space here where we can build stuff with. So I'm going to do is we're going to put, let's see here. Oops. Let's see. That was dumb. That was a Department of Duh moment. Nope. Double Department of Duh. Anti-dum-dum here. Let's go ahead here. I'm just going to do the blackstone first. Oops. Department. Ugh. Come here. Multi-department. Duh. Alright, now let's yank out our stairs of assorted types. Ooh, I kind of forgot about that. So we're going to have to go redesign that. Because I want the whole darn thing to be flush. All right. Excuse me. Let's see, I'm doing the thing. Gosh, that's making me think back to one of my... I know I've told this story before. Let's see here. Let's see here. Oh, we're gonna have to do something like this. Oops. That was smart. Let's see here. Get that out of the way. Get this stuff here out of the way. Get out of the way for the moment. This stuff here cleared out. What we'll do, let's do the smart thing here. We'll do essentially is we'll build stuff up instead of trying to preempt the overall design here, guys. What we'll do. Is let's see here. I'm gonna put that there. So yeah, instead of trying to pre, what's it? The design. What we'll do? Oh, geez, not glowy glow. That's dumb dumb. Well, actually, let's actually put, oh, that's an idea. Anti-mob system here. Let's see here. Let's use our brain place here, tree. Darn it, I cannot get, the Arch Illager rap by Dan Bull out of my canopy. Now let's see. Dan Bull, I have found, he can, I know I haven't seen all his vids, but, I've seen a lot of his Minecraft ones, as well as the one couple he's done with ERB, Epic Rap Battles of History. And it's a case of he does have some interesting stuff with that sort of thing, you know? Ow. Tree. Me and not using my buttons at the right time. Double dum-dum. Least the some of the physics in this game, while they're not realistic, make sense. Can also take advantage of the stuff. Oh. Jeez Louise. Hate when I do that. Dude. At least that one came back. Wait. Ooh, Tree just realized he needs to make a slight change to stuff here. One, two, three. Ah, yes, he does. Oops. Pick that guy up. Gather up that nether brick. We'll transform it all into stairs. I just realized that yeah, we need to have those guys up there. They all need to be what's Blackstone. Let's see here. Let's go around. Oops. There we go. Let's see here. I'm gonna go ahead here and put these two bad boys in. And I knew I was gonna have to get down anyway. Let's go make up another stack of basalt stair, black, blackstone stairs. I have to get all the way up. That's all right. I know that it's not the way I would prefer to do it, because I would, of course, prefer to have Blackstone as the back wall, but I'm not going to, in this particular case, I'm not going to really give a darn. Now, here I can. Here I can. Well, actually, we could put in the glowy glow. Use it as lighting. See here. Another brick. Alright, so one, two, break, one, two, break, one, two, break, one, two, break, one, two, break. Now, because that is the third one, and obviously we don't have glowstone in vanilla, that is cuttable. I'm not gonna worry about it. So let's see here. What we need to worry about now, get those guys out of the way. Come on, that. Get those. Get these, move out of the way. Boom, boom. Let's see here, one, oop, two, three. Gonna have an interesting little top here. Let's see here. Just wanted to make sure on that. Now we're gonna have to wrap up here pretty soon, so let's see here. Boom, boom. Keep that there. Because I can at least hop up there with the glowy glow there. Let's see here. I need to go. Let's see what else. I know I need to get some stuff. Need some dark oak. Dark oak is what I need. Mm-hmm. Get a look-see at this. Yeah. I forgot that. Well, that's all right. We'll get back up to there here in a sec. Of course, that is our way back up. Actually, that works. Look at that. Look at that. Oh, don't forget the glowy glow. a dum-dum tree. I'm suddenly thinking about the stuff from a Resident Evil Village. Lady Diamasco, however it is you say it. And when you see her in the trailer and, you know, you got the looking down shot and, you know, she looks right back up at the camera. I'm not a horror person, but they really did a good job of trying to, you know, do this. From my understanding, she's a pretty vain character in her own way. I remember seeing the trailers for it, and you know, her appearing, I think it's like towards the end, I think it was. All right. Let's take a look-see here at our wall. At least the segment we got started. Oh! Hoo-hoo-hoo! Yes! Now, true, part of my OCD is going, as I said, is going haywire because, you know, got the thing there of the whole blackstone without the interrupt of the glowstone, but I don't want the glowstone sticking out that, you know, that one corner. So it's a case of I'm just going to have to live with that. So let's go ahead here. We'll build this up to height. Oh, that's an idea. We need to go get light args. And, use ladders to, help, stuff out here. I have to redesign that, too. I'm thinking, taking a look at this, this is actually kind of bothering me, the way it sort of sticks out like that. Worry about it another time, though. Smarts. At least I'm getting my stuff back. Go put up a ladder. On this guy. I think I have some ladders over here. Yeah, I don't. Oh well. Not the end of the world. All we need to do is go outside. Drops food. Let's see where is it. There we go. Got our ladders. back on our lad args. But yeah. Let's see here. Let's quickly yank those guys out. In this case, actually, we need to be doing. This is the inverse theme, so we need redstone. I mean, not redstone, like. Actually, I can stay because it's already another brick. I'll put stairs right there. That guy could actually have stayed because he's already his thing. Department of Duh. Come on, there we go. Now I'm kind of thinking I may want to replace that with another brick as well. I'm gonna have to think about this. So what I'll do, we need to end stream. So what I'll do off camera is I'll get this side finished, get it done, and I'll take at least this guy here out and get him fixed up to another brick so it sort of matches. And then I'll decide on this guy how I want that done. So, yeah, I'm going to have to go ahead here and end stream, guys. Got to go to work. So, let me see who is live, who is live, who is live. So, excuse me. If you are watching here on Twitch at twitch.tv/OsageOrange01, please remember to go ahead and hit that follow button if you're watching over on the YouTubes over at youtube.com/OsageOrangeGaming. Please remember to go ahead and leave a like, hit that subscribe button, hit that bell icon for notifications. It really does help. And of course, make sure to follow me on Twitter at twitter.com/OsageOrange01. So, we're going to be saying hi to Beats over at Beetlebomb TV, formerly Beetlebomb TV, now just Beetlebomb. So go ahead and select our holiday raid message, which is the tree grove has arrived to bring you eggnog, tinsel, and good holiday cheer. Hope to get you guys on Saturday with another episode of City Building Saturdays, on Sunday over on YouTube with another episode of Titan Quest The Loot Grind. And of course, next Monday and Thursday, those are going to be our two bookmarker episodes of Let's Play Titan Quest, the Let's Play Minecraft Series 2. And then we'll be moving on to Let's Play Titan Quest Season 3 the week after that. So, let's go ahead here And let's get this raid party started. As appreciates everybody who has come out. Hope to catch y'all in the next episode. Ta-ta for now.